Gastroparesis is a disorder of the stomach where the stomach loses its ability to contract and doesn't empty, and then people develop symptoms of nausea, vomiting, upper abdominal bloating. It's been kind of a difficult disease to treat. There's been medications that we've used which are called prokinetic agents, which help the contractility of the stomach. Several of these medications have had severe side effects and been taken off the market. For people with gastroparesis that can't tolerate medications or the medications don't work for them, it can be an almost crippling disease. And people wind up having to have feeding tubes put into their stomach or into their small intestine. And a lot of times they'll have frequent admissions to the hospital for IV fluids. Sometimes people have to have what we call a central line, which allows them to have nutrition through their IV. And this is prone to infections and blood clots in their veins. So it can be an extremely crippling disease for people that can't get any relief any other way. Enterra Therapy is a neurostimulator of the stomach. We implant it in the abdominal wall and then place the leads in the wall of the stomach, and it provides electrical impulses to the stomach. What it actually does for the patient is decrease a lot of the nausea through the nausea centers in the brain through a neurofeedback. That's how it's believed to work, and it's fairly effective. Most people will get about a 70% reduction in their symptoms with Enterra Therapy. It's a fairly easy, safe surgery to perform. It is done under general anesthesia, and we do make two incisions in the abdomen. The stimulator is about the size of a cardiac pacemaker, and it's placed in the right abdominal wall through an incision maybe that's like 3 inches. And the wires run through the abdominal wall and then are sewn into the edge of the stomach. And then this applies electrical stimulation to the stomach, which we can control with a handheld device. Just by holding it over the stimulator, we can adjust the settings for it. Most people are in the hospital for 2 days. I've had some patients leave the next day. Some patients, if they continue to have nausea and vomiting, might have to be in the hospital for 3 or 4 days. What it does is provide a relief of the nausea, and which often decreases the vomiting that patients are having, and then helps them to be able to eat and live a normal life. It doesn't work perfectly for everybody, but I've had patients that it's been life-altering for. People have, come back and been so thankful. And it's been very rewarding for me to be able to help somebody that we couldn't find any other way to help. I've had some patients who have implanted the stimulator in who have had complete relief of their symptoms. I wouldn't say that's typical. Most patients probably get about a 70% relief of their symptoms. But for somebody who is absolutely miserable and this is a debilitating disease, for 70% can be life-altering in and of itself, can allow people to eat normal foods again, allow people to return to activities that they had before. For some people, it literally can be a lifesaver.